Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. What is going on? Are there two of me? Are we the same? What are we looking at?
When we have something that you can divide in half down the middle, and each side is the same, we call that symmetry. Symmetry can be found a lot in nature and can also be found a lot in design and art. With shapes, for example, a lot of shapes can be split right down the center and the left side will be the exact same thing as the right side, but there's a catch. It gets flipped over. So let's look at one very simple example. If I were to take a piece of paper and fold it in half and cut while it's folded in half, this shape, when I open it up, both sides will be the same, but this side is flipped, so it's the mirror image. It's like backwards. Another example, this is just an abstract shape, but if I were to take this and cut with the paper folded in half, when I open it up, I'm going to have perfect symmetry. So notice how this point is pointing out to your left, whereas this one, it's pointing out to the right, but if you folded it, it matches up with where it was on the other side. Lots of things in nature have symmetry. Different kinds of animals, leaves on trees, are all constructed with a general symmetry. An important part of identifying symmetry is finding where is the line where they are divided in half. That line is called the line of symmetry. Very creative name, I know. Once you find the line of symmetry, all you have to do is repeat what you did on one side to the other side, but flip it over. There are many ways with pieces of paper that we can do this, by either painting and folding so that the paint touches the other side, or folding and cutting both sides at the same time. But we're working in digital art now on the iPad, and this gives us an extra set of tools. There's a tool inside the Sketchbook app for your iPad that allows you to draw only on one side and it will automatically copy to the other side. This is very handy for an artist learning how to make digital drawings. If you're making something that needs symmetry, you only have to make one side of it and it automatically copies to the other side. It's also a cool way to make time-lapse videos of your drawings and see them appear magically. Here are some of the various types of symmetry. Everything on the left side is exactly the same as everything on the right side, but there's one line of symmetry. So that's one line of symmetry is when something is the same on either left to right or top to bottom. If you had two lines of symmetry, one left to right and one side to, or one up and down, then you could have four parts that are all equal. Each one is the mirror image of itself left to right and up and down, and you could trace two lines of symmetry. Now you can have more than that. One way would be what we call radial symmetry, and radial symmetry can be found in nature a lot. So think of like a flower with the center is a circle and then the petals of the flower are all the same and they kind of all come out from that center and they're all equal. So it's radiating from a central point. Also, starfish is an example of radial symmetry in nature. Lots of things have radial symmetry. If you look at it like the spokes of a wheel, so if you go out into a parking lot and you look at a car's wheel, if it has spokes on it, they must be evenly spaced. If they were not, your wheel would be lopsided, and when you're driving in the car, you'd be bumping a lot and your car would probably fall apart. It would at least be very uncomfortable. So the wheel is perfectly balanced with this radial symmetry. Lots of things that are engineered or made in a factory will be made with that perfect radial symmetry, whereas things in nature, it may be close, but it may not be exact. The Sketchbook app has a tool for making radial symmetry that makes it perfect every time, and it's very easy, and I'll be honest, it's quite fun to use, so we'll be looking at that too. All right, when you open the Sketchbook app, you can start a new sketch. If you don't know how to do that, You go to the file menu at the top left corner of your screen where the three dots and the three lines are. You tap that and you hit new sketch. If you like what you had on the screen before, when you hit create, it'll ask you if you want to save your previous sketch to the gallery. Like, let's say this was the greatest thing I've ever made. Well, when I go to do a new sketch and I hit create, it says, what do I want to do? Do I want to save current sketch or do I want to discard it? If it's the greatest thing I've ever made, I want to save it, so hit save current sketch. If I don't, I would hit discard current sketch, and it's going to ask me again just to make sure. So with a new sketch set up and my iPad going side to side, not up and down, I'm going to take two fingers on the screen and pinch them together just to zoom out a bit. Now I can see my whole white page. Before I start today, I'm going to make that white page a different color. So go to your color picking tab here, pick something different. Doesn't really matter what it is, just make it a little more interesting. Maybe like a dark purplish color. Okay, then tap anywhere outside of that menu to make it go away. Let's find the paint bucket tool. It's across the top of your screen and it is right here. It looks like a paint bucket. So if you tap that and then you tap anywhere in the white page becomes the color that you have selected. Now you have to hit the paint bucket tool again to exit, otherwise you'll just keep paint bucketing. Let's pick a new color. Pick something that will stand out against the background. Now two icons over from the paint bucket tool is the symmetry tools. Looks like this. Looks like two squiggly lines with a dotted line in between. When it comes up by default, it's going to have the option selected in blue that's all the way over on the left. That's the two-sided or bilateral symmetry. To show you what this means is that anytime I draw on the right side, it automatically copies to the other side. Remember where your undo button is, that's important. If you want to be able to lock that in place and not accidentally bump that circle in the middle and knock your line of symmetry out of the way, tap this lock right here over on the right. So now I can't move that line. Okay, so that's the bilateral symmetry option. If I want to add a line of symmetry top to bottom, I can tap the next icon over and make that one blue, where it's like an M and a W with a dotted line between it. I could either keep these on and it will make four versions of whatever I'm drawing, or I could turn off this one and now it's just the top to bottom. Well, that's cool, but we wanted to talk about radial symmetry. So this one next to it, where it looks like an X, that one's called radial symmetry, and you will turn the sections slider up. You could go as high as 16, but you don't have to. Just, you don't want to be down at like 6, because that's not enough for it to look like what we want. So I'm going to go to like 14. That's fine. Now, each one of these triangular pieces is all equally the same. So I will only need to draw in one of them, and the app will continue, it will copy it to all the other ones. So anything I draw in here is going to go automatically to all of them. Pretty cool. I can change colors and very simply add some other things. There's some additional features that you're not really seeing here that are kind of going on behind the scenes but you're not aware of yet. Up next to your slider for sections, so I had 14 sections, right? Well, if you look at the icon right to the right of that, it looks like a plus sign with some crossing lines on it. If I tap that, it says stop strokes at center line. Now, just to show you what this does, let me pick a color that's going to show up. If I start drawing right here inside one of these spaces and I try to cross over a dotted line, it doesn't let me. It stops me right there. There are some things that that's good for. However, when I'm doing radial symmetry drawings like this, oftentimes I want to be able to continue past that line and it will automatically copy around. So let me just undo all that white stuff and show you what the difference is. So now I'm going to start right here inside this circle, and I'm going to start drawing with white. See how it allows me to keep going and they all copy together? So it gives you this spinning feeling, and that's pretty cool. Now, if that's not what you're going for, then that's an issue and you want to uncheck that. But I think this looks pretty awesome. I think this is pretty cool. You can keep changing and adding colors as you go. So today I want you to play around with this and try to get the hang of how to use the symmetry feature and what kinds of different things you could do with it. I want you to try to make a radial symmetry drawing, and then we'll go over real quick how to submit it. So once you have created a radial symmetry drawing using this tool in Sketchbook, you're going to go to the three dots and three lines, the top left corner of your screen, the file menu, and you tap that, and then you're gonna see New Sketch, Gallery, Share, Preferences. You're gonna wanna tap the option that says Share. It brings up this menu, or depending on the software update that you have, it might be a different looking menu. But whatever menu it is, if it has a list or icons, you want to find the one that says Save Image and hit that. If it asks you if you want to allow it to access your photos, you would say obviously yes, I want it to, otherwise it will not be saving that image. When you navigate to your photos on your camera roll in your iPad here, that photo will be there. If you were to go into Schoology and try to submit this for today's assignment, when you create your submission, you would just select that picture.